When there's fire venting from the A side near the entry door with no other openings on the structure, it's easy to determine the location of the fire. In this scenario, a transitional attack may be the most effective way to knock back, confine, and suppress the fire. In this scenario, the fire is venting from the side A window near the door. No other vents are open, and the neutral plane is above the sill of the window. The lack of additional vents and neutral plane position indicate the seat of the fire is located in that compartment. When a transitional attack is chosen, the most effective method of initial water application to coat the most surfaces, thus providing the most cooling, is as steep of an angle as possible off the ceiling. Keep the nozzle as steady as possible. The nozzle firefighter should be constantly evaluating the effectiveness of water application, looking for indications that it's having an effect. The flames in the gas layer should begin to extinguish within seconds. If no effect is noted, the nozzle should be directed in a different location or possibly off the top of the window to coat surfaces. Once the gases have been cooled enough to no longer have fire venting out the window, the nozzle can be shut down to evaluate those conditions. There is no specific time limit or suggested flow time, as the time required for cooling should be based on conditions. If the water application is no longer showing signs of effective cooling, the application angle should be adjusted. Once the gases have been cooled and the nozzle shut down, the nozzle firefighter should apply water to any visible flame in the compartment. If visibility is limited, a half bail or narrow fog should be applied through the window in a wide O pattern to coat the most surfaces. Care should be taken to limit air entrainment by ensuring the nozzle is placed inside the window. If the suppression crew cannot apply water directly due to an obstruction near the opening or the elevation of the window, such as a second floor fire, or if the tactic is ineffective, they should rapidly transition to the interior once the gases are cooled. While relocating the line to the front door, the crew should pay attention to the conditions at the front door, evaluating for the conditions which indicate transitional attack was not effective. Consideration should be given to the line used for final interior suppression. The crew should utilize the most rapid method of transitioning. In some instances, this will be by relocating the initial attack line to the interior, and in others, it may be deploying an additional line for interior suppression. If more than one crew is available, consideration should be given to conducting simultaneous exterior application and interior advancement.